This video is sponsored by Shebop. Shebop is a woman-owned sex toy boutique for everybody, specializing in body-safe products and education. Visit sheboptheshop.com to shop online or take classes.
Our first topic tonight is going to be sex and introversion. Now, if you're anything like me, the word introvert conjures up this image of somebody who spends their days like in a dark bedroom reading a book or playing video games and has crippling social anxiety. And I'm pretty sure that that's an outdated notion from how introversion and extroversion are understood these days. So before we dive into sex and introversion, it would be great to get a definition that we can use for our purposes today. So I'd like to start with Rain. Rain, you do quite a bit of teaching in this area. So can you help us get a definition for tonight of introversion? How do you define that?
The standard definition that is pretty universally accepted for the difference between introverts and extroverts is that extroverts are actually charged and by interacting with other people. When they interact with other people, they get a charge like a battery. And introverts, it's the opposite. They can interact with other people, but it depletes their battery. And at a certain point, introverts need to be by themselves in order to recharge their battery. It is the exact opposite for extroverts. If they are by themselves and don't have other people to charge off of, they get very drained. So introverts can go out and be social, but at a certain time, the clock comes due and their battery is out. Whereas if you take an extrovert and put them in a room and they don't have anyone to charge off of, they're going to get twitchy. But like everything, it is a spectrum.
Yeah. Samson, I saw you had a little bit of a reaction to that definition of an extrovert or an introvert. Can I ask what was going through your mind there?
Rain described that beautifully. Rain said so many safe words. Rain said things like leave, get away from people, go home on time, leave at a certain time, be alone. Oh, my God. I was just over here like touching my nipples while she said all that. I'm definitely an introvert, but I do need some social interaction. But after a certain time, I need to be completely alone. And, you know, some people think it's weird, but I have always thought that you should like your own company. And I guess introverts, we like our own company a lot.
A friend of mine phrased it once, I think I identify this way, as she said that she was an introvert who really likes people and so is often mistaken for an extrovert. And I was like, oh, me too, that's me. But I'm wondering, Rain or anyone, being an introvert or an extrovert, is that different or than being sexually introverted? Or is that just kind of saying, I'm shy around sex? Because I know a lot of people that are shy around sex, but they might be an extrovert just because of the stigma and the shame that's been ingrained in us for so long around sex. So are we even talking about the same thing? I guess I kind of wanted to clarify that a little bit.
Oh, well, when it comes down to sexual introversion, now that can be fun too, because that means you don't got to stay up all night with another person. You mean to tell me I can have an orgasm and go to sleep on time? Yes, please.
This is where you and I do not see eye to eye, Samson, because for me, sex is literally a spiritual experience. Mm-hmm. And done properly, I like to craft it to a ritual that takes 6 hours and you need hydration breaks and watermelon slices and pineapple slices to keep your energy up. I like being fucked to the point that you are pushed through to another realm where I can see dead sober, I can see colors and hear voices and touch the fabric of the space-time continuum, and I literally don't know who I am anymore. When I get fucked, I want my soul touched. I want to be pushed through to that level of bliss where you can no longer walk. And you don't get that with 15-minute sessions.
Yes, you can.
That sounds like love right there. Wow.
15 minutes. I have had some glorious 30-second sexual experiences, but the ones where I actually get my soul fucked and can't walk, that's hours in. where you just, you don't know who you are anymore. You're just drooling in an undone puddle of bliss. 15 minutes for me is a warm up. That's yeah, a teaser. It's like, but get back to me when we can do 6 hours and I'm walking crooked for the next week.
But I think that's how it goes with vulva owners. It takes some warming up to do compared to, you know, people with penises. It's 15 minutes for, you know, obviously it's a spectrum, but it just goes off of, they don't need too much rev. Sometimes they do, but at most times, it's like going into the oven.
as a vulva owner, I have to admit that I'm probably a little bit outside the bell curve in that I literally need zero foreplay. I am constantly, wow. I don't, none, like, put it in. But once it's in, let's go for 6 hours until you have fucked my soul and I no longer know my name and I can't walk.